Weiter auch HW85-Test bei Air Gandhi. Servus, thanks for dropping in. It's time for another highlight, it's time for another Weihrauch. Today I brought a rifle that most of you probably don't have on their radar yet. It's the Weihrauch HW85. While scouting for new rifles or products in general to show in my reviews, I often check for other reviews and videos on the internet to prepare for my own. And the moment I finally hold a rifle in my own hands. For the HW85, I honestly barely found any information. I found some English videos, but I couldn't find real good information on this rifle. That's why I thought it's one more reason to review this rifle myself, just to find out if it is justified that there is not much information to find on it. We proceed as always. We take a closer look at the rifle, followed by the trigger test, the chrono test and the shooting test, and of course there will be my result at the end, where I will tell you who this rifle is made for. Okay, let's start. What you see here is a 116.5 cm long and very slim rifle. It weighs only 3.5 kg. For shooters that know a lot of guns, the HW35, for example, is 2.5 centimeters shorter but 300 gram heavier. Meaning, yeah, this one is quite long but slim and lightweight. Over here you can see the front sight tunnel with the sight plate on the inside. There are four more delivered with the rifle. The barrel right here is 50 centimeters long. There's also a HW85K, which is the short version with a 41 centimeter barrel. Right here we have the rear sight, which is fully adjustable sideways and in height. And again we have four more sights, which you can choose to install here. Here we see the walnut colored dark stained beech stock, which is smooth and without any chasing in the front. This is the trigger guard that holds the match trigger record. I think all the Weihrauch fans know it by heart already. I showed it a lot before. It is fully adjustable, meaning pre-travel, trigger pull and trigger weight can be modified separately. The grip has a nice chasing, the butt plate, I'll show you without destroying my lamp. Yeah, you can see this rifle is for right-handed shooters, so it's a little higher on the left side, where the right side of the shooter will be, and the right side is completely flat. And while I'm holding it, you can see the rubberized butt plate right here. On top of the system is a 11mm prism rail I used to mount a scope. Today I'm using a Hawk Air Max compact 3-12x40 scope connected with a Sportsmatch TO35C mount. The only thing left to mention is also very Weihrauch typical, the automatic safety, which activates while folding the rifle and has to be deactivated before every shot. Now I'd say we take a look at the trigger and test its weight. I just got my safety glasses and the Lyman trigger weight tester. Putting the glasses on. Over here, most of you know it, is my shooting gallery, which means I will just shoot into the next room. Nothing can break there. Grabbing a Diabolo. While it is open, here you can see the spring-loaded wedge closing. I switch the safety off. Activate the tester. And we have a trigger weight set to 820 gram. You can set the trigger to a lower trigger weight, Last time we had a trigger weight of 600 gram, for example. Enough with the theory now. Let's head to the practical part and take the Crony test as well as the shooting test. Now, this is the Crony test. We are taking 10 shots using Air Gandhi's Finest. The same we will use for the shooting test later. 0.56 gram, and we'll take a look at power and consistency. Okay, we took 10 shots, amount 10, average power 8.22 joules, average speed 171, ranging from 166 to 175, with a deviation of 8 meters, standard deviation of the medium is 2 meters. In my last video with the HW95, I already said it, don't panic if you buy a rifle with slightly more than the allowed 7.5 joule. It's all fine, as long as you didn't modify it, and the speed will lower a bit after a few hundred shots either way. The important thing is, don't modify it. It's approved and has the F on it, and you didn't change anything after buying it. Just stay clean with this topic, and now we'll take the shooting test. Here we are at the shooting test with the Weihrauch HW85. I zero the rifle in on the center, but I will check again in a second. I'll take 10 shots and see what the result will be. Here we go. The rifle has a pretty long barrel, or it's overall pretty long. If you have long arms, you get good leverage. Otherwise, when breaking the barrel, you just have to give it a little bump. You'll see that in a second. What stands out immediately, can you hear this? Exactly, you hear absolutely nothing. Nothing scratching, no grinding. Straight out of the box. There's a K variant, like I said. It's a bit shorter. It's probably a bit more handy, especially while sitting like me right now. And of course, if you're not that tall, the K version should come in handy. I think the long one looks just amazing, that's why I ordered this one. The rifle has a very low recoil. I think the first shots are proving it. I hope I won't mess up the result now. That was not an inner 10. The rifle has a very low recoil and it's super easy to learn to shoot with this gun. I had a much harder time with the HW95, but in the end you just have to get used to your rifle. Yeah. This one's extremely beginner friendly. 3.5 kilo weight is not too much, and also made for smaller body types. No, that was a 9. Oh, shit. It always happens when I think too much. Just shouldn't think about it and keep shooting. Nein. And one more shot, then we reached 10 overall. And that one was fully centered. Well, 99 points, which is a bit annoying. I'd say I can't end it like this. We'll go another round. Let's see if I can top the result, even when 99 points is really good already. Can't remember having this result a lot with a spring piston rifle. Of course, if you train a lot, you can definitely reach these results. I'll just take these 10 shots, hoping I can get a higher result. But yeah, we'll see. I feel even more comfortable than with a HW35 with this rifle, and you know how much of a HW35 fan I am. I probably made 10 videos alone with this rifle, if not more. But it's a really good question why I never noticed the HW85. Maybe it's just me in my bubble, and everybody else out there knew it already. The Diabolos fit perfectly. They fit in easily and don't come loose again. No. That's a 9, so it won't get better. Shooting distance is, as always with my Sportquantum, 11 yards. I always place it in front of my shooting gallery, which is why it's a bit closer than the gallery. We took 6 shots, 4 more to go. Yeah, that one was really good. And 3 more. That was number 8. That's number 9. Just saw it, a little bump, and it opens easily. Yeah, well, a bit sad, the fourth shot down there. Everything else was a 10. Five times the inner 10, and in the first round it was seven inner 10s. That was even better. Well, that's all complaining on a very high level. The HW85 is a ton of fun. Let's go for the result. This is the result for the Weihrauch HW85. I have no clue why I didn't notice it for so long. A super cool rifle. I love the design. If I have to decide, it could be I would go for the shorter version because I think it is a little more comfortable to handle. It's easier to break open, it's lighter, easier to transport. It is 9 centimeters shorter, so 107.5 centimeters. Yeah. Shooting is super comfortable and easy, even easier than the HW35, where I had a real learning curve. I don't know if you experience the same. High quality craftsmanship, but I think with Weihrauch I don't even have to mention this anymore. If you take care of this rifle, you can hand it down to your kids somewhere, and it's made for generations. I recommend using gun stock finish 1 to 2 times a year. If you put it away for longer, put some corrosion protection on it so you won't get any surface rust on it. I often have people asking me, hey, why do I get these strange dots on my rifle? And it's mostly after not using it for a while and you just got surface rust. Airgun's Finest are working really well. You can get the weapon care products, Finest, the scope and the mount in my shop. I don't have the HW85 in my shop yet. I really should think about adding it because it is an amazing rifle. It's good for the whole family. Like I said, with a smaller body type, you should probably use the short version. Otherwise, I recommend it to every hobby shooter and blinker. Really cool. I had a ton of fun. I hope you did too. Check my shop, jabolo.de. Maybe you'll find a few things. Christmas is coming. I hope you'll be here again next week. Thanks for watching. Ciao, Servus, es ergandi.